National would reinstate the sanction that penalises beneficiary mothers who don't identify the child's father. So is that going to help?
We want fathers to be financially responsible for their children. Tens of thousands of dads across New Zealand are, and we don't believe that there is a small group who should expect taxpayers to pay for their children.
But should children pay the price if, for whatever reason, which could be something like domestic abuse,
no, there's valid
the mother
exemptions.
Is not wanting to say...
No, there's a set of valid exemptions
that require
and
women
family,
to go and give
family
evidence
violence,
and humiliate and
family
expose
violence.
Themselves.
Just hang on a minute, Jan, I'll give you a moment. Sorry, Louise.
There are very clear exemptions in the policy currently. If there is family violence, if there's a threat of violence or any intimidation, if the woman doesn't know biologically who the father is. So there are set exemptions in place already.
But, Jan,
but
you're saying there are
obligations
issues around this?
Absolutely. We heard through the Select Committee when we were considering this under National, for a lawyer who was in tears from her sense of complicity of having to witness women's accounts of rape and abuse for them to be able to beg to get that money for their kids. It's a demeaning, disgusting
That's not what happened.
Happens
in MSD, and I would be offended on the staff's behalf for you to suggest that.
Can't,
that is not how they handle those cases.
Tracey, you want to come in?
Yeah, look, sorry, you know, as the Minister for Children for the last 3 years, these are adult arguments, right? Mm-hmm. But the children always pay. There are other ways to incentivise fathers to actually build the role of fathers inside of families than penalising children. There are other ways to actually support families into work, and that's what this government has done. We've funded things to much more careers advice all the way through life, and that's what we've put into place post-COVID. But to leave children in poverty and hungry because it's adults have got a problem with each other just doesn't wash anymore, surely.
If I can bring Carmel back in at this point, how many children have been lifted out of poverty in the last 3 years?
So, I mean, the most recent up-to-date advice that we've been given is around 18,500. And, of course, in February, Statistics New Zealand showed us that the progress had been made in 7 out of 9 of the indicators. So progress, obviously more needs to be made. But just on the issue around naming the other parent and getting rid of that sanction, can I say that I do agree with Jan and with Tracey. And also, it is a humiliating experience. I heard this too. Sometimes it was about the inconsistent way in which the sanction was applied, and sometimes women just didn't want to have to bare their souls to their case manager about the fact that they may have been raped, about a domestic violence situation. And so we've taken that away, and I think it's, you know, dangerous and highly offensive that National are even considering putting it back in when we finally made some progress.
And we're seeing 12,000 more children in material hardship under this government before
not
COVID.
You're
not solving the challenges for the most challenged families.
Put an additional $34 into the pockets of those mothers.